What I have here is just a bunch of regular sand, and I really want to try turning it into some spontaneously combustible gas. It's also relatively easy to do this, and I'll just get started by quickly adding some of it into a small beaker, and then on top of this, I'll dump in the only other ingredient that I'll need, which is some powdered magnesium metal. Now with both of these loaded in, I just need to mix them together, and after stirring for a few minutes, it's looking pretty nice and even, and I can pour it all into a big test tube. I'll also cover the top with a bit of extra sand, tilt the whole thing on an angle, and add this Bunsen burner. With all of this in place, the sand and magnesium should slowly heat up and gently react. Except that isn't exactly what happened. I think this is just because I used a bit too much powder though, so I quickly set it up again, using much less, and I was a bit worried that this would also explode, except it actually worked. This was because this time, all of the sand and magnesium was thankfully able to react, leading to the formation of something called magnesium silicide, and the entire thing turned red hot. It was actually so hot that it was able to melt a lot of the glass, and what I think is really interesting is that as it gradually cooled back down to room temperature, it all slowly cracked. But anyway, at this point, the reaction is done, and what I have to do next is take the tube off the stand, carefully place it onto a piece of paper, and gently tap it to break it apart. I'll then just quickly get rid of the unbroken tube, crush it into a nice and fine powder, and get rid of as much broken glass as possible. And now, it's finally time to make my spontaneously combustible gas, where all I have to do is take this powder and dump it into some mildly acidic water, and almost immediately, I'm breathing with a bunch of little fireballs. This is because all of the magnesium silicide is being turned into scary silane gas, which is then immediately igniting when it touches air, and this reaction doesn't last for very long, but I still think it's pretty cool.